topic before us tonight is advancing in the world and taking charge of your life. Advancing in the world and taking charge of your life. Praise the Lord. The Lord is expecting us to become advanced. And the only way to become advanced is only through the Word. Praise the Lord. The only way to become strong and mighty is by the Word. Praise the Lord. The only way the Holy Spirit will listen to you is when you approach Him by the Word. The only way heaven will pay attention to what you're saying is when you speak the Word, because God honors His Word. He said, I watch over my Word to bring it to pass. Praise the Lord. His ears are open to hear when you speak His Word. Praise the Lord. So He said, He gave me this topic this morning. He said, advancing in the world and taking charge of your life. So actually, He wants us to take charge of situations and circumstances that surround us, and have the ability to deal with it comfortably, confidently, and correctly, and change things that we do need to change. Praise the Lord. He said to me, a lot of people are cranky, jumbled up, you know, angry, or have been praying, no result. The Word of God has gone through. Now, God wants you to learn how to take the bull by the horn. He said to me, he said, when you get courageous enough and you learn how to, you know, the bull will stand on your way. And when he stands on your way, he's coming out for you. And if you block, he's going to take you down. Praise the Lord. So he said, learn how to do what? Take the bull by the horn. Because the horn is his place of power. When you learn how to handle the horn, he has no ability. And then you can take him off your way and go through. Praise the Lord. He said, you are not allowed to be vulnerable. He's the one talking now. He said, I should write. He said, you are not allowed to be vulnerable to anything at all. He said, nothing has ability to unseat you, because there is power that worketh in you that supersedes all other powers. Praise the Lord. He said, nothing has ability to unseat you. Why? Because there is a superpower that dwelleth in you. Yeah, because all power belongs to God. All power belongs to Him. And He is in you and you are in Him. Praise the Lord. So all power was made by Him. Whether good one or bad one, praise the Lord. Everything hailed from God. According to the book of Colossians, if the word of God be true, then it's true. Colossians chapter 1, verse 16 and 17 says, all things were created by Him and for Him, be it thrones, dominion, principalities, powers. Do we get it? Everything was made by Him and for Him, and they exist or consist by Him. And He said, anything that was made without the Word was not created at all. And not just is created by the world, everything is answerable to the world. Everything responds. That is the meaning of consisting, existing. Praise the Lord. That is why Hebrew 1 says, upholding all things by the power of his word. He's upholding his everything he created by the power of his word. He's ruling the everything he made by his word. They obey him. Praise the Lord. Now he is in you. What is the difference between you and him? I gave us an example of when we were dealing with the glory of God. That I was praying for someone. And actually the person was a child, not an adult. You know, the ones that you think they don't even understand what we're saying in the church. But that child was filled with the Holy Spirit. As I lifted up my eyes to pray for that child, I saw the glory on the bed. And I said, Lord, I'm looking for this person. I want to pray. And the Lord said, she is my glory. Wow, I was shocked. I was amazed. Full of light. Probably does not even know more than 5 Bible passages to quote. Do you get it? So when you receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you have received God in totality. When you see yourself in the realm of the Spirit, you are the glory. God does not see your flesh. He sees himself in you. So when you stand and speak the word, when you understand what you are doing, you begin to get results. He said, become advanced. Do you get it? God wants us to move from baby Christians, just quoting the word and walking away, getting deeper, where you take the word for whatever it says and apply it. You know, speaking the word is different. Meditating on the word is another level. Then application of the word is a higher dimension, whereby you use the word of God to solve problem. You apply it, and you'll be amazed that creation is obeying and answering to the word of God that you're speaking. Because when you speak it, creation doesn't see you. Creation see God because you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Do we understand what I'm saying? When you begin to say, I am the glory of God, you're entering into agreement with God. You're saying, yes, Father, I am what you said I am. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So now, your job is to just speak the word and speak the word. From speaking, because your faith needs to be alive. The word of God said, faith cometh by hearing by the word of God. So when you say to yourself, Father, I thank you, for I am the glory of God. I thank you, for thou art in me and with me. I thank you, for thou hast promised never to leave me nor to forsake you. Now you're changing your mindset. Do you get it? Our mind function with information. So you're inputting, you're programming your mind. You want your mind to function in a way it should function. Do you get it? And the moment your mind gets it, your faith will move. When your faith moves, power also moves. Praise the Lord. So I don't want you to sit down and just quote two scripture Bible, you know, passages, walk around a few minutes, and then move. You should train your mind how to be in the spirit. Because that's where the job is done. It's a be advanced. Sit down, focus. Train your mind from wandering from Sokoto to Kaduna, from Cork to Dublin, from Canada to America, even in 1 minute. Your mind can go to all those places in 1 minute. Do you get it? And then you are ranting words. If someone asks you, are you praying? You say, yes, I have prayed for 5 hours today. You hit your chest and say, yes, oh, I really pray today. But actually, you just wasted your time. God doesn't function like that. He said, be still, for I am God. When he said be still, he means your mind, everything, 100% attention to him. Then when he knows that you're looking and you're paying attention, then he speaks. So when he moves, you know. And he's not going to move unless you're waiting for him to move. So when you're doing the word of God, you're expecting that word of God to come alive and be what it says it is. And when it springs up, what do you do with it? You solve problem. I was giving an example. Let's say you want to create a new business. You have no cash. You have nothing. Only with the word of God, you can do it. Praise the Lord. The word of God is the only place that will give you the truth. It's the only word that sets you free. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. He said, it shall make you. You already set free. Make and set is not the same. Making you free means that in your mind now you know it, you're free. Setting you free means he has already set you, even though you didn't know it. You already set free. He said to me this afternoon, I was talking to him and I said, Lord, he said, oh, I have done that 2016 years ago for you. You only got it now. He said, now, walk in it. Do we get it? Imagine this little boy here. He has an inheritance. Whatever his daddy has is his own. But that little boy is not going to get nothing until he grows and become a matured man, responsible, have understanding how to manage the property. No father wants to hand in a key to properties while he knows the son is irresponsible or has no understanding in the management because he has labored for it. It's the same way. God expects us to come. He said, come thither. Come to the throne of grace. Come and receive grace and be all that you are supposed to be. Come, my abilities is available for you. Yeah, you have it already. He said, all has been given to you. That's why he said to Abraham, look, see, He said it in Revelation again. He said, I set before you an open door. But see. Why will God tell you see? You have to have understanding. That is the see. No matter how much I preach it to you here, no matter how much I push it, quack it, if you don't get it, you will not be able to walk in it. Simple. It's just like someone going into mathematics exam. You know, English, you can construct some things and get few marks. But mathematics, if you don't know it, you fail woefully. I don't know if I know everybody here has done maths in one way or the other. In primary school, secondary school, you have done maths. When you're stuck in the formula, you're stuck in it. When the 2 is supposed to be hanging up and you put it down and put the B up and the Y down, you just fail it. The teacher, there is no mercy. It's the same way with the kingdom of God. Everything is set before you. But your job is to discover what you have. He said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. You can just quote it and walk away. We have been quoting it just like we were quoting the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, and armor. You know, 9 of it in Sunday school. Not until I got the revelation of it that you actually walk in these fruits daily. You apply them daily. Because that's the way God helps people. If God is going to show up in your house and take you throughout the day, how is he going to walk with you? Because it's a spirit. Do we get it? Let's say you're a businessman. How do you want him to help you? You have to understand how he helps businessmen. You need to know the word of God that covers that aspect. That when you're speaking to him, you're speaking to him by the word. So when he springs forth according to the word of God in your mouth. To be all that you have said. He said, I watch over my word to bring it to pass. So when you say, out of my belly shall flow rivers of living waters. It's not complete. The Holy Spirit is stuck. What river do you want him to flow? He said rivers. He is the living water. The rivers is his functionality. Is he walking? Do you want him to flow to you today as peace? Do we get it now? So when you're saying, Father, out of my belly shall flow abundance of living water. Abundance of what? Anointing for what? Do we get it? So be specific so that you will be able to get good results. God will not move. I'm sorry to tell you this. God will not move. God does not walk without understanding. His name is understanding. He will not function with you if you're foolish. Because he will not know how to help you. I've walked with God in ignorance for years. God will show up, I mean with white robe, sitting at the feet of my bed. And I don't even know what to tell him. I'm sitting down here for hours, enjoying the presence. Sometimes 3:30, I say, Lord, can I go to bed now? If it's now, hey, I will ride on the eagle's wing. I'll go and solve problems somewhere. If Jesus showed up in my room now, in this my naked eye now, hey, he will walk and be tired. Are you getting it? When he leaves my door, he will say, bye. Because the last time I saw him, he said, now I'm walking away. I won't be back in a while. But when you do need me, I will be back. He walked off through the window. A few years ago, I've not seen him like that. I see him casually now. But now I've come to know the Holy Spirit who dwelleth in me. Are you getting it? He's my companion, he's my friend. So every morning I know the rivers that I need. Tonight I say, Lord, what are you? He said to me, I am the living word in this season for you. Because I tried to call him name, I call him my daddy. He said, no, I'm not your daddy in this season. I'm not your husband in this season. I'm not your lover in this season, which is a season of serious business. I want to give life to the words that you are speaking, to create things that you need to create, because you need to move forward. Are you getting it? So you might be finding God as your friend. Friend is someone you chat with, you spend quality time with. You might be finding him, you might be his servant. There are categories, there are different times, but then you can also determine what he is or what river he's going to flow in a particular season and be consistent until you produce what you desire to produce. Do we get it? What is your desire? What is your desire? A child told me, oh, mommy, I want to do Proverbs chapter 8, verse 21. He said, he traversed in the path of righteousness to give wealth to those who love him and fill up their treasuries. Yeah, it's beautiful. But there are things that will come before that. He said, those who love me, there is condition attached to it. So there is a place of intimacy. Loving someone is not just, I love you. It's not a mouth thing. It's not a saying thing, it's a relationship, it's a deep relationship. It's whereby you know him one-on-one. Whereby you can hear him clearly. He gives you an instruction where the channel is going to come through. What company do you belong to? Where do you buy shares? Do you create something? Do you invent something? Are you getting it? Wealth is not going to fall from the ceiling. He might give you a link to an oil company, and you join them and begin to lift oil or do some business with them. Do we get it? So when we quote this Bible, we should know there is a place where you set yourself to receive what you're looking for in the physical realm. You don't just sit in the house and pray. Elijah prayed, he sent his servant, he said, go check. He prayed again, he sent his servant, go check. Do we get it?
Bro John, when God said, okay, I'm giving you abundance, he said, now go and learn how to make food. Do you get it? You are fully loaded, you're heavily anointed now. But then there are areas that you need to fix, that you'll be able to be connected to the financial world. Then when you get there, the anointing will begin to work. So when you're speaking the word of God, when you get there, you know how to channel the anointing. That as you get up in the morning, you know the specific anointing to stir up. You know the particular word to use. For the earth and the fullness thereof is mine. Fullness means everything in it is mine. Because he's in you. You are in him. So when you speak, he is speaking. When money is listening to you and obeying you, it's not you. He's obeying the Holy Ghost in you. Because you have become one with him. So it's not enough to speak the word. You find him by the word. He said, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, then you shall go forth and bless the demand, and heaven will make it for you. The earth will produce for you. Praise the Lord. So it's not a one-way traffic thing. You have to understand that you should be balanced in understanding, balanced in wisdom, balanced in knowledge. So when you pull a Bible passage from Proverbs, you pull one in Ecclesiastes, you pull the fourth one in Romans, you combine three of them, you create something. And most times the Holy Spirit will ask you a question. He say, why? Do you think what you're saying is okay? Why do you think I'm going to do it? And you, on his face, you say, Daddy, because your word says this and your word says that, and I believe it. Sometimes he will ask you, you said it, but you don't believe it. Because it's not about quoting, it's not about saying it. Do you believe it? I believe 100% in divine healing. But if my faith is not alive, that anointing will not flow. Do you get it? And when it's not alive, I go to the chemist and I buy a Kapol. Is it Kapol? What do you call it?
Kapol.
Yeah. If my faith is not functioning, I go and get it. Do you get it? But when my faith is alive, that's why you keep praying for one thing, you pray for it, pray. The faith is not there. You pray for one thing, pray it over and over and over again, you quack it, you push it. No, stop pushing it, go and buy something. Or wake your faith. He said, faith coming. Sometimes I say, Lord, what do I do? He said, meditate on the word. I say, okay. I go. I say, Lord, my faith is not there. I know when my faith is there. You know it. It's like this, Pam. You don't need to say it twice. The problem is solved. And sometimes you solve it then, the enemy will come back and try your faith again. And know whether, but when you solve it, you lock the door and throw the key away. And say, look, I'm finished with this. I don't want to go back there again. Praise the Lord. Don't know if we're getting what I'm saying tonight. We need to be advanced in the things of God and what we're doing. Let's say your case is devil troubling you. Because some people, bad dreams, fighting the dream, you know, problems or from problem. What do you need to deal with that? Let's look at Colossians chapter 2. 14 to 15. He said, having wiped out the handwriting of requirement that was against us,
which was contrary to us, and he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross, having disarmed principalities and powers. That's my very sweet one. He made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it all. Praise the Lord. You see, there is one thing I have come to know. When the enemy comes to fight you, he comes with fear. He might grab your neck, grab any part of your body, put nails on your body. You know, just give you some scary dreams. He wants you to panic. He just wants to cover your environment with darkness. Now, it's wrong for you to just get up and start fighting. You're not properly equipped. You'll just waste your time. And he's not going to unhook you. The more you pray, the more his grip is increasing. Because you don't understand how to fight him. Do you get it? So now, personally, when the enemy comes at me like that, I just smile. I smile and I laugh and I say, sorry? What is that? I tell him, you have lied from the beginning. So you can't lie to me, now I know you. Jesus took your power. So which one are you coming to contend with? And each time I say you have been disarmed, the grip will be losing. It weakens him. Each time you say you have been disarmed, it becomes weaker. Each time you say you have been disarmed, he has disarmed principalities and powers. Just keep saying that word. And I know deep down me what I'm saying. So it's not about what I'm feeling. I might be feeling pain, but from what I know, I can deal with the pain. Do we get it now? So you don't allow the devil beat you down, put you under the duvet, and you're there making hoping that someone will show up and deliver you. Most times no one is showing up because everyone is busy. So now your job is to manage and grab the Bible. You have phone. If your Bible is heavy like this type I carry, you carry your phone. Touch it, the touch screen. Look for your Bible. Look for Colossians. Look for Ephesians. By the time you finish reading it, keep repeating it for him. Don't move from there. Jesus didn't go to bind the devil. He didn't, not even for once. He didn't waste that time. He had too much to do. Whenever you spend time with demons and devils, you are wasting your precious time. It's a time you should use to create things. You should use to apply the word of God to change things around you, change things in the life of people around you. He said the word of God is sharper than two-edged sword.